A helpless dash a sympathy. The helpless dash are sympathy. What are the options? We have require, B requires, C does require, and D do require. Do requires. Well, look at this. First of all, even without looking at our sentence, we may remove D, because that is an awkward grammatical construction. Do, once we use the do verb, then whatever comes in here, whatever verb that comes, name verb, because it's being used here now as a helping verb to require, which is the main verb. So once the do comes, the main verb cannot take on an S. So that will help us to remove D. If you have that in your mind, you know that principle, and that will help between A and C. Now remember that our basic rule is that singular subject takes singular verb. Plural subject takes plural verb. So the helpless, what do we consider it? How do we consider it? Is it a singular subject or a plural subject? Now, what we have here is not a clear case now. It's actually an adjective. With the noun, it's supposed to modify removed. For example, we have to say the helpless boy, the helpless girl. Now, the noun is not there. But we can also have a situation where helpless modifies a plural noun. The helpless people, the helpless boys. So it can modify both singular and plural nouns. So, which one is removed? Now the principle here is once the noun is removed and you have the definite article before the adjective, it is considered as plural. And because of that, our verb will have to be a plural verb. And the plural verb that we have here is a require. So our answer is therefore require. To agree with the plural subject, the helpless. So this question again is linked with another aspect of English. So you work them together to bring up your answer.